Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having a fantastic day. So this morning, Matthias and I left Switzerland and we flew to London.
Make sure the seat is adjusted to your height. For comfort and control, grasp the wheel like this. They are the drivers who see.
To our hotel room and we're so excited to be here because we are attending the Summer in the City event. I told you guys about this like so many times because I'm really excited. It's basically a big YouTube convention. It's kind of like VidCon for Europe at the moment. I know that there's going to be a VidCon in Amsterdam in 2017, but at the moment this is the biggest YouTube event in Europe, so we're really excited to attend. It's 3 days long, so tomorrow we are attending a creator day, which is like learning about YouTube, like I don't know exactly what it's about, but it's for like people that make YouTube videos. And then the next 2 days, it's like a big party and convention, like with, you know, panels, and you can go learn things and talk to people. So yeah, we're really excited to meet other people that are obsessed with the internet like we are. So basically, I just wanted to make a quick little video showing you guys exactly what we packed, because I was gonna film a video yesterday showing what we're packing, but it was kind of hard because there were some things that we throw in last minute, you know, like toothbrushes and stuff that you throw in the morning of your flight. So I thought it would be clever to do like an unpacking video. So I'm gonna show you guys everything that we brought with us to London for a 1 week trip. And I have to say, personally, I'm pretty proud of myself because typically I'm a very big overpacker, and this is the first time that I really feel like I packed the perfect amount of stuff. Like, not too much, not too little. It's very lightweight. I brought everything in a carry-on bag, you know, the one you put in the overhead bins. And yeah, I am pretty proud of myself because in the past 1 week, especially if I'm going to an event or something, I would have brought so many clothes. But I love my new wardrobe, and yeah, I'm excited to show you guys. And Matthias is gonna give you guys a peek as well at what he packed. So let's get straight into my suitcase. And if you guys like these types of videos, if you want to see more like real life type of things where I'm showing you instead of just telling you, make sure you give this video a thumbs up so I know to make more videos like this. And yeah, let's get started. So first off, this is my suitcase. It's just a little like carry-on that fits like all the standards for like the small planes over here, and I got it at Goodwill when we were in the US, so I think I paid like $5 or $6 for it, and it is in really good shape. We literally just sprayed it down with the hose when we got back from Goodwill and left it outside to air out, and it's literally as good as new. So I'm super excited about this suitcase because we tried to go buy like new carry-on suitcases looking for them on sale and stuff, and we could not find like a decent one under $50. So we really saved and scored big time finding this one at Goodwill. So I'm super excited. First trip with the new suitcase. I'm such a dork. Okay, so everything that I brought, let's just go through it, shall we? First of all, my little travel makeup bag. You guys, I did a video showing everything that is in here a few months ago, maybe a month ago, and I can guarantee you it's still the same stuff, so I'm not gonna go through all the makeup that is in here, but if you're interested, everything that's in here, there is a video. I will link it down below. You guys can go check it out. So I need to bring my makeup. Obviously, this is, you know, a pretty big supply for 1 week, but I like to do my makeup. I like to have some options, especially for an event like this where it's like some day and night things, so I want to be able to switch it up. So check out that video if you have not seen it already. Next is just my liquids. Here in Europe, you can bring as many liquids as you want as long as they're under 100 milliliters and that they fit into like a clear plastic thing, which is really nice because in the US you can only bring 3 liquid items, which is always really difficult for me. So I was super excited when I found out I can bring as much as I want. So what I bring as far as like liquid toiletry type of items, I have a few little travel size shampoos, 2 of these, because yeah, to be honest, I could use this all up in like one wash, but I'm gonna try to make 2 of these last me all week. So just shampoo, a mini conditioner, makeup setting spray, I have my Double Wear foundation, a face cream, some eyelash glue, and that is about it for liquids. We did realize upon getting here, like, you know, we don't have hairspray for Matias. He likes his hairspray. So there are a few things that we will go buy, but it's not really a big deal. We'll just head to the local grocery store and it will be fun anyways, going in an English grocery store and just kind of checking it out. So if you do forget something, it's never like that big of a deal because, come on, they're gonna have it where you're going, and sometimes it can be a fun little adventure. Next, I also brought this little pouch that I keep all of my hair ties in. So this is just all of my hair bands, hair clips, and little clear elastics for when I do my braids and stuff. So I just bring that with me. It's like a really small, convenient little thing. I really like it. Deodorant, obviously you need that. Okay, now into the clothing. This is where I am so proud of myself that this is 1 week's worth of clothes. Because usually I'd always bring like backup options and backups on backups options. So I think I kept it quite simple this time around, and I'm really excited about it because it made traveling so much easier. So first I have, in addition to the shoes that I wore today, which were just some booties, I brought these heels that I really like to wear with like ripped jeans for going out at night. So I think there are some nighttime events, or definitely we will go to like a pub or something. So I like to wear these kinds of heels, and these are super comfortable, you guys. I really like these. I brought an umbrella that's always useful because when it rains and you forgot your umbrella, it's annoying always having to buy a new one, so I try to remember to pack one so I don't end up like buying all these umbrellas and keeping a stockpile of them. Okay, and then as far as tops, we are here for a week, so I brought 7 like shirts, like t-shirt type of items. Sorry, they got a little bit mixed up in the flight. Normally they would be folded a bit more nicely. But yeah, you can see everything is neutral, which makes it so easy because I don't have to stress about things matching or not matching. Everything kind of is interchangeable, which I really like. But I have some that are more for going out at night and some that are for day and some that are perfect for both. And then to go with the tops, I brought 3 like sweaters slash jackets. So I have 2 kind of like knit pullover sweaters that I can throw over any of the t-shirts that I brought to just be more comfortable, whatever, you know what I mean, just to have an extra layer. So I have 2, again, they're neutral, so I can layer them over any shirt that I brought. If I would have a green sweater and it only matches like my green or my white shirt, then this one is more like a jacket for nighttime. You can see it has like these fake leather arms and it's black, and it looks really sleek over like a tank top with some ripped jeans or black jeans at night with those heels that I showed you. It's such a cute outfit. Hopefully I'll wear that one night and I can show you guys like the whole look in a vlog or something like that. But yeah, I really like this jacket. And then I brought 1 other pair of jeans in addition to the ones that I'm wearing. So I'm wearing some black jeans right now. And I brought these lighter wash jeans in addition to those. Like, these have some holes in them, some really big holes in them. They used to be smaller, but they keep growing on me. But I still like these jeans a lot and they're still wearable. So I think that these are cool for daytime with like some booties and just like a basic t-shirt. So I definitely can imagine I'll be wearing these most of the week. And then of course, pajamas. I just brought 1 pair, just some flannel type pants and a white t-shirt to go with them. And then in addition to the purse that I carried with me on the plane today, I just have 1 small purse for going out, again, for walking around at night so I can have my hands free. And again, black goes with everything, so always makes it easier for traveling to bring things in neutral colors or in black. So I definitely will be wearing this when we go out at night. And then of course I brought, you know, 7 pairs of underwear. I'm not going to show you guys all my underwear, but I think 1 pair of underwear per day is pretty sufficient, and we can always do a load of laundry if we really need to. Again, for me, this is not a lot of clothes. Maybe for you, you're perfectly good at wearing like, I don't know, 3 t-shirts and then washing them and wearing them again. But for me, I think for a trip like this, having 1 shirt per day is a pretty good benchmark. I'm really excited because having these options that I love is just going to make the whole trip so much more enjoyable because I won't have to stress out about what I'm going to wear every day. They're all just clothes that I love and that I'm so comfortable in. And also, I got a lot of people commenting why my wardrobe is so like dark or dull or neutral when they think that doesn't really suit my personality. And I mean, maybe that's true. I used to wear a lot more colors and prints and things like that, but I was always carrying around a lot of clothes every time we would travel, and I'm just so happy having these neutral clothes because it makes my life so much less stressful, and I'm all about simplifying, especially when you're traveling. I just want to pack up and go, and when we get there, I don't want to have to run around and buy items. I just want to be happy with what I brought, and I'm really excited. So that is about it for my suitcase. Now Matias, his is going to be a lot faster than mine because he packed a lot less than me. So here is Matias.
Okay, now I'll show you what I packed for this trip. Here is my suitcase. I bought this one in Florida as well as Sarah did. at Goodwill. I paid maybe like $6 for it, so that was a pretty good price for this nice suitcase. So let's go into what we have here. Here you go. This is not my purse. This is Sarah's purse, so it didn't fit anymore in her case, so she gave it to me. Here we have a deodorant. Floss, always good. This is my reflector that I use quite frequently for our videos. Next, umbrella. Always bring an umbrella because it just the rain just comes out of the blue sometimes. This will be my nighttime outfit, so we might go out over the weekend, so I have a white undershirt and a nice Oxford shirt. Next section. Sleeping shorts. I can also go running with those. Here I have 6 or 7 pairs of socks. These are my undies. Don't need to show these. So I always wear black t-shirts every single day. So I brought just my black t-shirts. And I wear my jeans right now. But now I'm gonna show you my gear that I brought with. We have my laptop. This is my microphone case. 2 chargers. One is for the SLR. One is for the G7X. Charging cable. This is Sarah's Numi wand for her hair. More charging stuff for some headphones. And Sarah's laptop.
Alright guys, that's it. That's all we packed. I hope you enjoyed looking in our suitcases. I know it's kind of weird, but maybe you guys found it interesting or helpful in some way. We love you guys so, so much. And we'll see you very soon in the next video. Bye. Bye. Bye.